Philippine Senate President vows the upper chamber will scrutinize the confidential and intelligence funds in the proposed 2025 national budget. The Marcos administration, in its budget proposal submitted to Congress on Monday, is seeking nearly 6 billion pesos for intelligence funds, which is meant for military in uniform branches of government. It is also seeking 4.36 billion in confidential funds, or those for civilian agencies. Senate President Francis Escudero says the so-called spy funds are better off in the hands of law enforcers than civilian agencies. Japanese tire giant Yokohama delivers on its 3.5 billion peso investment pledge to the Philippines. The company on Monday began the construction of its new manufacturing plant at the Clark Freeport Zone in Pampanga. It's expected to produce 500,000 tires annually. 94% of its output will be for exports, while the rest will be for the local market. The Yokohama plant is also expected to add 500 new jobs for Filipinos.
A year since the law establishing the Philippines' first sovereign wealth fund was signed, its manager, the Maharlika Investment Corporation, is ready to invest. MIC President and CEO Rafael Consing Jr. told ANC they are focused on investing in energy, security, healthcare, resource development like mining, and broadband. He adds once the fund starts investing, this will pave the way for more foreign investors to come into the country.
In respect of FDIs directly, the Maharlika really is the collaborative vehicle that the government created in order for them for us to be able to attract FDI in the country. Once we establish these investment platforms to a certain scale, then all the more we'll be able to attract foreign investors who want to be able to come in, you know, in significant amounts. They don't want to come in small amounts, in trickles. So they're basically looking for scale, and that's what we're aiming to build. And that's how we will be able to contribute to that.
The Philippines' outstanding debt projected to balloon to a record 17.35 trillion pesos in 2025. Based on the budget department's outlay of expenditures, the country's outstanding debt is projected to reach 16 trillion pesos by the end of the year, amid prevailing high interest rates. As of May, the national debt stock stands at 15.3 trillion. The budget department's principal economist, Undersecretary Ocelito Basilio, said Monday, the government is accelerating debt payments thanks to better tax collection and more business transactions.
A proposal is filed at the Philippine Senate to all but ensure the exit of offshore gaming operators in the country. The proponent of the measure, Senator Joel Villanueva, said this would revoke all POGO and other related licenses issued by the gaming regulator, PAGCOR. It would also give POGOs 30 days to cease operations or risk jail time and a fine of 100 million pesos. The bill repeals the 2021 law taxing POGOs and allows the Revenue Bureau to collect their unpaid taxes after. The filing of the measure follows the pronouncement of President Marcos to ban the crime-riddled industry by the end of the year. The Philippine banking sector's loss absorption buffers can observe the impact of government's ban on offshore gaming hubs. That's according to credit rating agency Fitch Ratings. Fitch believes the POGO ban will hurt real estate firms' rental yields. But larger real estate players can withstand at least a 15% drop in their EBITDA without affecting their debt servicing capacity, thanks to their diversified portfolios. Fitch also does not expect significant property-related losses with POGO closures due to current rules surrounding banks' capital ratios. Regulations currently require banks to demonstrate a Common Equity Tier 1 ratio between 6 and 10%. President Marcos Jr. announced during his state address, POGOs must cease operations by year-end.